Alright, folks, well, here comes another video and another new idea. This one I've had rummaging around in my head for, I don't know, a couple months now. Ever since I've been trying to get back into making videos, I've actually had this idea, but obviously I've been too lazy and too caught up doing other things to make it. But this is another test run of a series idea I've kind of had. I don't know exactly how long I can make it go or how fleshed out I can make it or how many ideas I even have for it, but I may or may not dabble in reading fan fictions every now and again when I'm bored or I'm perusing around and I see an idea or a plot synopsis that really gets my attention. And sometimes they're good. Sometimes they have a good story. Sometimes they're written more professionally than you could ever imagine someone having the ability to write, especially on fanfiction. Sometimes they're not even that well written, but they have enough heart, enough pride in their own material that you kind of go, you know what? Yeah, this is not bad. And then sometimes you read stories where you, for whatever reason, read the first chapter, knew it was going to be shit, and then decided to keep reading. Or you read the first, like, let's say five chapters, you get to the sixth, you realize the entire story has been leading up to a fucking lemon, and from then on there's a lemon every fucking chapter afterwards. And if you don't know what a lemon is,
let's fuck! I'll fuck anything that moves!
It's sexy times. And wow, you just get really fucking disappointed, not only in the story, but in yourself, because you kept on going when you had the ability to stop. I've done that quite a few times. So I'd like to take the notable honor of having, what's the joke I'm trying to make here? Because I completely botched it. I'd like to have the honor of stating that I have forced myself to read a bunch of garbage and have come to recognize certain tropes, especially within the Star Wars fanfiction community. And I thought it'd just be fun to talk about some of the tropes that I've noticed and why they're bad, or why I think they're bad. And the first one, as the title may give away for the video, the Almighty World. To give you a general idea of this one, I've read a couple fanfics, again, somewhat off the cuff is how I am, of Star Wars stories. They tend to be in the Empire era, like episode 5, 6-ish, usually in that like sweet spot in between or just at the tail end of 6. And regardless of how well they're written, this trope infects stories that could be well written, could be terribly written, and it brings the entire immersion to a crushing halt. And it bothers me on a very fundamental level. The Almighty World is generally a single world. It can sometimes be a whole system, but it's usually just one world within the system that, for whatever reason, is so powerful, so all-consuming, so important, so resource-intensive, so etc., etc., that they can somehow do amazing things, and they're only now being brought up.
By the power of Grayskull!
What do I mean by this? Well, a couple of points. It apparently supplies half the fucking universe. I've read some stories. I'm not going to name any stories unless they're exceedingly bad, because, you know, sometimes people who are writing, they just want to try writing. They're not that good. So these could be their first stories or whatever. But I've read some stories where you get one world and the Empire, I'm going to use the Empire, but sometimes it happens to the Confederacy or even the Republic. The Empire apparently gets half of their everything from this one world, even though the galaxy is so much bigger than this one world. And let's say, a rebel, someone important, some character goes to the world and is like, we need your help to bring down the Empire. And they talk to an exceedingly well-receiving politician who's like, oh, we can't get involved in the politics of the Empire. The Empire is so very powerful. They go out of the scene for like a chapter or two or a paragraph. They come back, oh, we've decided to help the rebellion. And because they've decided to join the rebels, somehow the entire Empire's infrastructure comes crashing down, collapsing under the weight of one world turning against them. Some of the things that go along with this trope, they sit on a very important trade route or a space lane. So, if the Empire and this world aren't working side by side, the entire economy of the galaxy, half of it comes crashing down. Or, better yet, this is one of my favorite aspects too. I read a story once where that exact scene I just said happened, where, I'm not going to give too many details, a important character from the original trilogy is talking to, like, the representative or governor or president of the world of some planet, and he's like, the rebellion really needs your help right now because we've been badly beaten and bruised. And this guy's like, ugh, we just don't want to get involved in the war going on right now. We're a peaceful planet. He says, as he sits on this trade route, like I just said a minute ago, that's very important to the Empire, and this planet somehow maintains a military that can, I don't know if it was exactly match the Empire, but rivals it in some way, or has some sort of threatening position to it. And all I gotta say is, man, you were on some delusional shit if you write a story where one world, one singular planet, without a valid fucking excuse, has the military capacity and ability to match, if not outright supersede, the military of the Empire. The Empire mass produced on a scale that is insanity. Like, the Confederacy of Independent Systems mass produced on a level that is insanity. So you're gonna tell me rando world XYZ has a military force numbering in the septillions, and they have warships numbering in the quintillions? That's just a number I made up, but they have it. And so in this story, what happens is this fucking planet decides to join the rebels, and they all show up where this important Imperial fleet is, and because they sat on a trade route, they cut off the trade route to the Empire. The Empire couldn't get a fleet to support their fleet, even though that's not how hyperlanes work. And this rando planet's fleet somehow wiped out, like, the most massive Imperial fleet. And because of this, the rebellion was victorious. Do you know the kind of political repercussions that would have if one world could take the credit for bringing down the Galactic Empire? They would immediately supersede Coruscant's importance. They would immediately impress upon the entire galaxy their military and political clout. And you've got yourself a single planet that has marginalized an entire galaxy. Fuck you. I mean, this was bad even when SWTOR did it with fucking Valkorion and Zakuul, but at least they had the excuse of some magical fleet that came from the ass end of space that no one knew exactly where it came from. But I digress. Similar point to the one I said before, they have a monopoly on resources, but this one's a little more specific. They have a monopoly on a certain material or a certain substance. Like, if this one world trope had the one world producing something that's even more powerful than Colto, if I could speak, or Bacta. Like, I know, what is it, Boda? I know that that's better than Bacta, but that actually had, you know, legitimate in-universe repercussions in Legends, and they took care of it, and they're like, well, we're not going to be able to produce any more Boda. So Boda stops being a problem at that point. But what I'm talking about is planets that have some made-up crap, like, you know, unobtainium or something ridiculous like that. They produce it for the Empire, the Confederacy, the Galaxy, the Republic even, and, oh, if this big galactic power somehow invades us, they'll lose access to all of that material. even though that kind of is the point of imperialism, invading a territory that has a resource that you need, you defeat the natives there, native population, you subjugate them, and then you just take what resources you want. It's stupid, like, it's like, what are you talking about? If made-up world XYZ is creating, let's say, Boda 3, it's even better than Boda 2, and the Empire catches wind of this, you bet your ass they're just gonna invade you, maybe slaughter half your population, and then make you mine the Boda for them. More likely they'll just bring in droids. My point being is that it's dumb. It's really dumb. Sometimes there's vague reasons why the planet isn't invaded by the Empire or is almighty and powerful and won't be stopped. Is because they're friends with the Empire, or they're friends with the Republic, or they're friends with the Confederacy. But it's always vague as to in what way this friendship actually works, because they always write it, at least in the tropes that I'm talking about, where, yes, we have to go to this world. Not that world, yes, that world. This world that stands outside of the laws and bounds of the Empire, the Republic, or the Confederacy of Independent Systems, because they do things together, maybe. Even though, like, the Republic, you can get away with it, because they're kind of free association a little bit. Confederacy? No. Empire? No. Rebels? Yes, because they're not really a galactic government, they're a rebellion.
I rebel.
No. No. No.
Or even like the Sith Empires of old. Pick any one of them. And again, it forgets the fact that the Empire, to be fair, like I've said, most of the time this trope pops up during the Imperial versus Rebels era, so that's why I keep bringing up the Empire as the main point. But this still ignores the fact that the Empire could invade them, conquer them, like they do for tens of thousands of worlds. Yes, the Empire has conquered tens of thousands of worlds, or subjugated tens of thousands of worlds, or quashed rebellions on tens of thousands of worlds, because their military is so vast that they could beat this world to a pulp and take it for themselves, regardless of why they need to be friends, which is always vague anyways. And then there's also the vague stories where, like, this one world or system got into a conflict with the Empire, and somehow they managed to win. Usually they have some bullshit super weapon, like, the authors go out of their way to, like, make them have a... Oh, they have their own, oh god, what's it called in Corellia? I am forgetting what it's called, and I feel really bad. Centerpoint Station. It's like if the system had its own Centerpoint Station, and they could activate it and use it whenever they want, and instead of trying to destroy the Empire, they're just like, no, you stay away from our system, you hear? Because we're good Christian Star Wars civilians. It's stupid shit like that. They have some magical weapon or military power that somehow makes them untouchable or not worth the trouble, that even Vader's like, oh, we don't want to deal with that shit, even though Vader, in his masochistic conquering way, would be like, oh yeah, I can take care of that, fuck it. He's done crazier shit. He stabbed himself to kill a Darth Maul clone. I mean, come on. And then, kind of as a final kind of like tick, there's always the ones where they have some magical being or magical, like, cabal of people on the world, like prophets of the dark side or something, where it's like, we know how to use the Force, and we have hidden this planet, and we have been amassing a military power, or they're like, you know, some Sith cult or sect that has been building an army of Sith minions. There was one story I read where, God, what had happened? Now, this one actually took place right after the Clone Wars. In the previous story, Anakin had defeated Palpatine before turning to the dark side, so he was happily living with Padme. I think this story is so obscure, I don't mind talking about some of the details. Grievous was still around. Or no, Well, maybe Grease was killed. I don't remember. But basically, after the Clone Wars, something, there's some evil new Darksider out in the galaxy who's like a shapeshifter or something, and he's somehow amassed on one planet an army of Dark Jedi and Fallen Jedi. Like, I'm talking Dark Jedi numbering in the tens of thousands on one world. And we don't get any information as to how they've been fed. We don't get much of information on how they've been gathered. It's just kind of a bunch of people who are pissed off. Some fallen Jedi from, like, the old canon's like, "You're alive? We thought that you had died." "Yes, you thought I had died, but I realized that because no one came looking for me, that I had to take revenge on the entire galaxy." Like, what the fuck are you talking about? But that's a whole other trope to talk about at another point. But, yeah... It's funny because the story ends with the clones who are like on military retainer at that point show up on the planet and they just murder all these Dark Jedi. It's a really bad anti-climax. I mean, I could go on, but really, I'd just be repeating like the same points before, which is more specific kind of reasons why it's a bad trope. It's a bad trope, people. If you're someone who likes to write or even read fan fictions, this is a bad trope. A single planet, no matter how amassed a military they may have, cannot fight an entire galaxy. I am sorry, it just cannot happen unless you have a really well-written reason as to why. They need to have somehow superior technology, and then they need to have applied it to enough resources to make the Empire actually second guess going against them. And even then, the Empire and the Confederacy both have the same thing in common. They have enough men and droids and ships to throw at you that they don't care about collateral damage or losing. They're like the Soviet Union in World War II. They don't care how much material they lose. They'll just beat you through attrition. Eventually, you're just going to run out of manpower or materials to keep up the war. And we always have fucking Vader and Palpatine. If Vader can't crack a planet, Palpatine, I guarantee you, would be so pissed off, he would show up himself and go, "I'm handling this," and he'd fucking just, I don't know, force-storm the entire planet into oblivion. I mean, this is the Empire we're talking about. Or they'd send the Death Star, and it's like, I don't care how powerful your weapon is, you're not going to destroy the Death Star unless you're Luke Skywalker, and then you have plot armor. But plot armor is a weapon that very few people have. Unless you're Disney, then you just give it to everybody. Having a planet have some form of significant political power is not bad. It just has to be regional. Like, let's think. Like, you know, Corellia. Corellia is really important regionally because they sit on the Corellian trade route. They're the end of it. And they have very powerful manufacturing and technological corporations that supply parts of the galaxy. They produce and manufacture weapons and designs that the Empire, the Republic, all of them buy and try to use. But they're regional. If the Galactic Empire had risen and Corellia decided they didn't want to have anything to do with them, but the Empire wanted the shit Corellia is producing, they would just invade Corellia and put them down. You know, it doesn't matter how good a single planet may be. It doesn't matter the culture or the style or the mannerisms of a single planet and its people if it's facing against a galaxy. Like, everyone loves an underdog story, I get that, but sometimes people go to illogical lengths to give a reason as to why the world they have built would not have been conquered or can even supersede the Empire. Once again, if your world is strong enough to topple an empire, then you need to damn well write a sequel where that planet tries to impose its will and its needs on the entire galaxy. Because at that point, the galaxy can't do shit. If you hear about planet XYZ took down the Galactic Empire because they cut off trade and had a fucking navy big enough to bring down the largest Imperial fleet somehow, then I'm sorry, you just win. It's like having a Mary Sue or Gary Stu just turn that character into a planet. And yeah, it's not good. It's not a good story. It's not a good idea. It's not a good okay, to kind of top it off, you can make it interesting, but it has to be logical, usually regional. It has to have reasons, and you have to go into depth as to why those reasons are there. And you have to have just good writing skills. Like, if you're going to do this trope and you want to make it work, you have to be able to write it effectively. Sometimes people try to write these stories and they can't write as well as they think they can. And I say this as someone who likes to fictionally write every now and again. Maybe not fan fictions, but I like to fictionally write every now and again. I dabbled in the past, but I don't do much anymore. Like, I know that there are some things I would never be able to pull off. Like, if you asked me to write a romance novel, prepare to be fucking disappointed, because I don't get it. I don't have the writing ability to create something like that. I can try, and then by, you know, trial and error, maybe I'll get better. But if you're gonna go off the bat with this trope of the almighty world, as I call it, I'm sorry, unless you are a writing genius who can pull off intricate reasons as to why, when, how, and where, you're writing yourself into a fucking corner that you cannot escape. Anyway, that's the first video of the series. If you guys like it, I will make more. If you don't like it, tell me all about it. Leave a comment, you know, if you guys want to support me. I mean, I'm trying to be a little more, like, respectable here. If you guys want to support me, I do have a Patreon. It'll be in the description. It's also going to be at the end of the video, probably showing up sometime after this. Again, like I said in my announcement video, if you can't support me on Patreon, it's totally okay. It's just if you want to. It kind of would help me in the future make more videos, but I am not trying to impart upon everyone else my needs. That being said, again, if you guys like this series, let me know. I may make more. And, yeah, Tiber is... You know what? I was going to go into an actual ending. I refuse to do that. I will see you all later.